technique college on the Fort Wayne campus here, and we're promoting our advanced automation robotics technology program. We're about to enter into one of the most exciting rooms that we have here on the Fort Wayne campus, where we do a lot of our project-based learning. So I first want to point out that our program here has won a national recognition for being an exemplar program, so quite an achievement, and you know, we're very proud of that. We've got an excellent staff here that's really largely, you know, responsible for helping us to earn such a prestigious award. So we're going to go in and take a look at some of the neat stuff that we have to show you in here. So first of all, you can see here some of our projects that we've done in the past. We like to promote and get out into industry and show some of the neat things that our students are actually doing. So this is what we call the Mad Ants basketball launcher. Both of these devices have been used at our D League here at the Ivy Tech Community, our Fort Wayne Memorial Coliseum. I believe their affiliation with, I'm not sure what their major team is, but anyhow, we will use this equipment to demonstrate and showcase some of the things that we've done. So the first time we did this particular Mad Ants 1.0, this was used to actually deliver the ceremonial ball launch. But I'd like to point out that, you know, these projects are extremely vigorous and require a lot of help and effort to do. So this one here was a collaboration with our machining program, our engineering program, our automotive program. So we kind of all work together to put the mechanisms in place to make it actually happen. So the drive system on this was actually designed and fabricated and built by our engineering team. Well, I need to turn the controller on, and I'm going to turn this one on too as well while we wait for this to sync up. But it's a collaboration of all these programs that come together to build some really neat projects. So here you can see we can make a turn and rotate and twist, and the idea was we would run this out to center court, we'd push a couple of buttons, and the ball would launch up, and then that would be the game ball that would be used. So this is our 2.0 version of that particular project. So you can see there's some very exhaustive wiring diagrams that go into this particular system here. Again, this is all student-built, student-driven, and again, a lot of collaboration went into this with our engineering programs. The engineering program actually designed and built the drivable base for this one. And we used this at our basketball games in a free throw shooting type of contest. So we would have our machine down on one end, and then a contestant from the audience would be down on the other end. And the idea was who could make the most free throws in 30 seconds. But I want to just kind of open the cabinet here and give you an idea of what the system actually looks like. So there you can see, again, a lot of electrical controls are going into this thing to make it actually do what it needs to do. So in this particular system, we've got relays. Again, relays are used to transfer the higher current levels that we may need. We've got what we call PWMs, which are pulse width modulators, which are going to be used to control the distance of how far we want this thing to go. And this guy right here is actually a PLC. So it's a 5-volt PLC. So a little bit different than the PLCs that we saw earlier, but it still does the same type of work. It's going to get input information, and then it's going to drive output information. We'll get the two systems to sync up, and then we should be able to drive this particular robot. We would line it up for the three-pointers. And then we would just try to make as many as we actually could. So I'm going to line this up just a little bit and see if we can't launch a ball for you real quickly. I think we'll do better with this one. Okay, so see the lights are flashing at a certain rate. It's actually been programmed where we can make it flash even faster. So again, high-tech skills, highly in demand. Okay, so we're going to go back to the slower flash here. Not sure if the camera can see this or not, but we've got mirrors on the front of this particular machine where I can see how fast or how much voltage and how much current the overall system is pulling. So I'm going to turn the motors on. And then if I needed to, I can adjust the elevation. So I'll show you how the elevation works. So if we wanted to change the angle per se and maybe have a higher arc or a lower arc, we would then just kind of play with the elevation of the ball monitor. And hopefully it won't. Hopefully we don't hit anything. There we go. So again, high-tech skills here that we're teaching and highly, highly, highly in demand. So I'm going to move this guy out of the way. We're going to come to our next piece of equipment that I'd like for us to look at. This is a project that was done in one of our projects in manufacturing classes. This is where the capstone, not necessarily the capstone, but students are actually going to take all of their skills, compile them, work together in a team atmosphere, and do some electrical stuff, do some mechanical stuff, do some PLC programming, do some robotics programming. So this is really cool because we've got some great industry partners here in Fort Wayne, and they actually donated this Mitsubishi robot. So our charge was to get it fired up and get it running as a system. We're going to come over here to our Shuttleworth conveyor here, which is another high-tech piece of equipment. Again, industry donated. This piece of equipment has a lot of the modern-day technology on it. So again, it's got PLCs, it's got variable frequency drives. It's got sensor technology in it, and we're going to use this to teach some of the components that we call mechatronics, PLCs, and just be able to get this thing to do something. So these are the actual prints and drawings that we received with this guy. So here you can see a lot of electrical drawings that we're going to teach in the program and get you to be able to read and interpret. So, all right, so I'll push the button here, and hopefully we'll get a little bit better luck. There we go. So again, this has been programmed by a student in our PLC classes using what we call sequence logic to turn motors on and slow them down and to stop things here. And then it should come down here and be able to transfer back and forth a few times. Done by design, how many times it goes back and forth, and all part of our PLC program. So we're very fortunate to have a lot of industry partners. Again, so this was donated by a company called Shuttleworth, and we're able to introduce some very high-tech skills into our program. So this is our welding robot here. We've actually taken this particular robot and we're multi-purposing it. So we're either doing pick and place with this robot, or we can actually connect the welding attachments to it and actually do some robotic welding. Over here in the corner, we can see that we have our ABV robot. So this was an actual very exciting project where the robot again was donated by one of our local industry partners here. The students were challenged with coming up with an cell enclosure, and then it took about two or three semesters, and we were able to resurrect this robot and get it up and running, and now we're incorporating it into our program. So the first robot that we saw was actually a Mitsubishi. This robot over here is a FANUC, and this robot over here is what we would call an ABB. So all very popular robot brands that are used in the industry. This is an example of some of what we would call our mechatronics equipment. So mechatronics is electromechanical types of pieces of equipment that are designed to work together. So it could be an electrical problem, it could be a mechanical problem, it could be a pneumatic problem. It could be very many different types of problems that prevent this equipment from functioning. But its overall idea is that we're going to put something here, a process is going to happen. We'll see if we get lucky here. Okay, so I push the button, I got the part to be fed forward, I push it again, another action happens, and again, this is all because of the PLC. If I flip it into auto mode and push the button, it should then continue to operate on its own. Now it should either pick that part up or reject that part and put it on the conveyor line. this is kind of what we would call cellular manufacturing, and at each station, these pieces of equipment are going to be designed to do a particular task. This is another one of our student-built projects. So this was actually a piece of equipment, again, that was donated by our friends at 8020, and we were able to retrofit this into what we call a can crusher. We build a lot of automated can crushers here at Ivy Tech because it'll teach you those fundamental skills of how to wire something up electrically, how to go ahead and add the pneumatic control components to it, and then associate that PLC to it. So here's that HMI screen that we saw earlier in the PLC lab. You can see we've done a real good job of putting an Ivy Tech logo on there. We've got auto controls, we've got manual controls, we've got maintenance controls, and the electrical control panel being right down here that's actually driving that particular machine. This is our what we call Ethernet I/O down here. So we've got our pneumatic control systems there, and then all of our inputs and outputs are actually being driven through that particular block. So lots of great equipment in this room. I'm going to go over to the FANUC robot over there next and show you how those particular pieces of equipment actually function. So this is what we would call a jointed axis robot. And these are becoming very popular in industry and are being used to automate a lot of various processes in manufacturing facilities. But a skill to be able to pick this pendant up and be able to manipulate that robot is a highly demanded skill. So I'm going to see if I can get this robot to actually do a little bit of movement for me. So again, I've got to know which buttons on this particular teach pendant to press to get the robot to do what it is that I want it to do. So I can make it go up, I can make it go down, I can make it reach in, I can make it reach out. And again, just being able to pick this particular teach pendant up, manipulate this robot, maybe start it up for production, maybe something went haywire in the process and you have to be able to reset that robot and get it to a point where it can be restarted again, is a tremendous skill that's highly in demand. And that's a part of our, we have three of those particular classes in the AART program. We've got Automation Robotics 1, Automation Robotics 2, and then soon to be even including Automation Robotics 3. Well, we're going to give you FANUC certifications. So a big part of the program is industry recognized certifications, which we haven't talked a whole lot about, but if you go through our programs here at Ivy Tech, you're going to earn a FANUC Robotics certification. So again, we got some more robots over here that are very similar to that guy that was being a little stubborn for me earlier, but hopefully this one will work for us. I've staged him. Hopefully all I have to do is hit the start button and it'll work. Yay. When technology works, it's awesome. When it doesn't work, that's our charge as technicians, is to be able to get that thing back up and running. So this is a robot that's been programmed to, just for our sake here, pick up blocks, move them down. Why does that conveyor belt stop? Well, it's seeing information. It's being driven by the PLC down here. So now it knows that there's a block there, and it's ready to go pick up that block. So while that's doing that, I'm going to turn this guy on. And hopefully we can get this little guy down here on the floor to do something. If I turned it on, hopefully. So these are what we call VEX robots, and they're a combination of some electrical skills, some mechanical skills, some robot scene programming types of skills, and we're going to introduce these into our program. So we're going to do a lot of project-based learning in the AART program, where we can have a lot of fun, learn a lot of those fundamental skill sets that are in high demand, whether it's formulas, whether it's math, gear ratios, you name it. We've got a lot of skill sets that we're going to teach you in the program. So, yeah, none of this stuff just works right out of the box. We've got to teach those fundamental skill sets in order to be able to get them to do our desired results. But anyhow, I thank everybody for chiming in today and taking a quick look at some of the cool things that we have in our program. AART, Advanced Automation Robotic Technology, it's a skill set that's in high demand, whether it be here in Fort Wayne, Kokomo, Terre Haute, Muncie, Lafayette, State of Indiana, huge, highly demanded skill set across the nation as well. Jobs ranging anywhere from, you know, $17 up to $30 an hour. Plenty of openings out there. In my particular area here in Fort Wayne, we have graduates that are having no trouble whatsoever actually finding openings upon graduation. So if this is something that looks interesting to you, I would tell you to look up your local Ivy Tech campus, maybe talk to your program chairs out there, and they would be happy to sit down with you and share with you some of the exciting things that are going on in their area. So again, thanks for joining. Appreciate it. Have a great day.